In this video, I'm going to show you how to make the journal entries for a byproduct when a company uses the sales method. So let's do an example. So we've got a company that makes one main product, lumber, and then they happen to get a byproduct when they make the lumber, and that byproduct is wood chips. They end up with 4,000 pounds of wood chips, which they're going to sell for $1 a pound, and they happen to sell 1,200 pounds in the current period, which is December, but then let's say that December 31st is the fiscal year end, and in the next period, January, they sell the remaining 2,800 pounds of wood chips. So how would we account for this? Well, first of all, we're not going to make any journal entry at all until the byproduct is actually sold. Okay, so we're not going to have a byproduct inventory account. We're not going to do anything like that. But when we actually sell the byproduct, so for example, in December, when we sell the 1,200 pounds, we're going to recognize $1,200 of revenue. And not just any type of revenue. It's going to be other revenue. It would be in the non-operating section. Okay, so let's walk through the journal entries and see how this would all play out. So let's assume that the company bought $150,000 of raw materials, which would be trees, for cash on December 3rd. So we've got $150,000 of raw materials inventory, but then they put all of the raw materials into production. They're all used as direct materials. So we're gonna debit work in process inventory, credit raw materials inventory. We're just transferring from one type of inventory to another. Now we incur some direct labor costs, we debit WIP inventory again, the company applies $80,000 of manufacturing overhead, we debit WIP inventory again. So now WIP inventory has been debited for $150,000, $20,000, and $80,000, so that's $250,000. So when we actually finish producing the lumber, we're gonna credit work in process inventory for $250,000, and we're gonna debit finished goods inventory related to the lumber for $250,000. Now notice, we do not set up any kind of an inventory account here for the wood chips. That's different than the production method. In the production method, basically we're offsetting some of the cost of producing the lumber. So the lumber would be debited for $246, and then we'd have a byproduct inventory account that'd be debited for $4,000. We're not doing that here. Under the sales method, we just record the inventory for the lumber. Okay. Now, when we actually sell the lumber, let's say we sell all the lumber, we're going to recognize cost of goods sold of $250,000 and then credit the finished goods inventory for the lumber. And then let's say we sold it for $300,000 on credit, we're going to credit revenue for the lumber. Now, this is when we sold the lumber here. This is not the byproduct. When we actually sell the byproduct, which in this case is wood chips, remember, when we sell the 1,200 pounds of wood chips at $1 a pound, we're going to credit revenue for wood chips. And specifically, this is going to be an other type of revenue. It's going to be in the non-operating section on the income statement. Okay, so this transaction is going to affect the company's profit, but it's going to be in the non-operating section. And then we just debit accounts receivable, assuming that we sold the wood chips on credit. December 31st is our fiscal year end. We don't have any wood chips in inventory because we never set up an inventory account for it. Then in January, we sell the remaining wood chips. There's 2,800 pounds at $1 a pound. So we will credit, again, revenue for the wood chips. And again, this is going to be non-operating. This is going to be other revenue, other income, that sort of account. We're going to credit that for 2,800, and then we're going to debit account receivable, assuming we did this on credit. Now, notice that the income statement effect is affecting not just December. So we've got December, we've got this period here. There's $1,200 of revenue effect from the wood chips, but then there's $2,800 in the next period. So because we didn't sell all the wood chips in December, and we still had some for the future period, there's two income statements that are being affected. So December's income statement and January's income statement are both being affected by the wood chips. If we had sold them all here, if we sold all of them here, then we would have credited other revenue for $4,000, and the entire income statement effect would have been in December, and nothing would have went into January. Why does this matter? Because actually a company could kind of use this as a means of earnings management. If you have a bunch of wood chips or some other byproducts sitting around, there's no income statement effect until you actually sell the byproduct. So if you're having a tough quarter or something like that, you sell the byproduct, now you get that boost to your company's profits. So again, the income statement effect is, we don't have any journal entry at all for wood chips until we actually sell the wood chips. And when we do sell it, then we have other revenue.